Hello students, welcome back to e-learning session of GS College of Commerce, Vardha. This lecture is for the BCom Sem 5 English medium for the subject Indian Economy. As far as the subject is concerned, under this we have completed our first two units and we were dealing with our third unit, that is population and unemployment. So in third unit as well we have completed our first chapter, that is population. Now we are dealing with our second chapter, that is employment and unemployment. So under this chapter we are going to see meaning of employment, then structure of employment in India, and then in second portion, that is unemployment, we are going to see the meaning of unemployment, then various types of unemployment, then causes of unemployment in India, then the remedies to solve the problem of unemployment, and then the government measures taken to remove the problem of unemployment in Indian economy. So that is what we are going to study under this chapter. So let's begin with the meaning of employment. If I'll ask you a simple question, what is employment? So what's going to be your reply? Most of you will say that holding of a job and getting paid for it is employment, right? Yes, in general terms, it is holding of a job and getting paid for it. But mere holding of a job and getting paid for it is not full employment. Now, we can understand this with the help of an example. See, a person who is an engineer is working somewhere and he is getting only 5,000 rupees per month. So can you say that he is fully employed, or is he going to be satisfied with the sum of rupees 5,000 per month when he is well qualified, he is well educated? Of course not. Why? Because he is not getting the job as per his expectation. He is not getting the salary, he is not getting paid as per his expectation and the qualification and the skills. Therefore, he is not fully employed. Okay, so employment means, employment is not that simple term. It doesn't mean only holding of job and getting paid for it. But employment is little difficult term that we are going to see in the meaning. So let's see the meaning of employment. See, employment indicates a state of anyone who is doing what under the circumstances he most wants to do. Such a person is fully employed. Now we will understand this meaning with the help of an example. See, if a person is well qualified, say if a person has an engineering, okay, or if a person has a CA or the CS degree and he is working as per his skills, as per his qualification, and he is getting paid as per his qualification, expectation. So in that case, in that circumstances, we can say that the person is fully employed. Okay, as we have discussed in our earlier example, if a person who's engineer and who has qualified the examination, who's possessing the higher qualification, but he's getting very low paid job, and in that case the person would not be called as fully employed. Okay, so in actuality, what's going to be the full employment, or to whom you can call the fully employed person? When a person is doing the job which suits to his qualification, which suits to his skills, and which he is ready to do, and which is giving him returns as per his expectation. So in that case, the person is known as fully employed. As we have seen the example of CA working in a consultancy firm, CA who is working for a company and is getting 50,000 per month. So in case, we can call him fully employed. Okay, so this is the meaning of employment. Now we are going to see the structure of employment in India. Okay, So when we talk about the structure of employment in India, so it is basically divided into three categories that we are going to study here. That is sectoral distribution of employment, then organized and employment in organized and unorganized sector, then rural and urban employment. So let's start with the sectoral distribution of employment in India. So in Indian economy, there are basically three sectors, that is primary sector, secondary sector and the tertiary sector. Tertiary sector is also called as service sector. So let's see what is primary sector. See, primary sector is the sector which includes agriculture and allied activities. Allied activities basically consist of forestry, fishing, dairying, etc. And other activities like mining, quarrying also comes under the purview of primary sector. So when we talk about the contribution of primary sector in Indian economy, so it occupies 41.49% of India's population, means it provides job to 41.49% of India's population. 41.49% of India's population is dependent upon primary sector for their livelihood. And when we talk about the contribution of the primary sector in the GDP of our country, so it is 17.76%. I'm giving you the data of year 2020. So contribution of primary sector in India's GDP is 17.76%. So it is the contribution of primary sector. The next sector in Indian economy is the secondary sector. Now what is basically the secondary sector? Secondary sector is a sector which consists of construction, okay, which basically consists of industries, constructions, etc. And when we talk about the population working in this sector, so it is 26.18% population depends on this sector for their survival, for their livelihood. Okay. And when we talk about the contribution of this sector in India's GDP, so as per year 2020, it was 27.48%. Okay. So secondary sector also contributes to Indian economy, and it is also one of the important sector in Indian economy. Then we have the tertiary sector. Since last few years, tertiary sector is expanding, and when we talk about the tertiary sector, so it employs 32.33% Indian population, means it provides job to 32.33% of Indian population. And it is a sector which contributes the most part of our GDP. It contributes 54.77% to India's GDP. And the contribution of the tertiary sector has been increased since last few years due to expansion in the financial and other services. Okay. So as we have seen, basically there are three sectors, primary, secondary and tertiary. Even though the primary sector occupies most of India's population, most of India's population depends upon the primary sector for their contribution, for their livelihood. Still, the contribution of this sector in India's GDP is least one. So this is the sectoral distribution of employment in India. Now we will move to the next point, that is organized and unorganized sector, means employment in organized and unorganized sector. So if I say organized sector, so what is mean by organized sector? See, organized sector is a sector which is incorporated by the proper authority, which follows the rules and the regulation of a proper authority or the government, that comes under the organized sector. And what is unorganized sector? So unorganized sector is a sector which is not incorporated under any proper authority and which does not follow the rules and regulations laid down by proper authority. As it is not incorporated under any authority, so the rules and regulations for this sector is not let down. So that is called unorganized sector. And when we talk about the structure of employment in these sectors in Indian economy, so unorganized sector occupies major chunk of population. Means major chunk of Indian population depends upon unorganized sector for their survival, for their livelihood. Means major portion of India's population is employed in unorganized sector. If you are going to see, so whole agricultural sector and most extent of construction and the industry also comes under into the unorganized sector. If you are going to see the purview of organized sector, so it is quite limited in Indian economy. Okay, it is restricted to some big industry, it is restricted to some formal institution. If you are going to see the education sector, if you are going to see the financial services sector, if you are going to see the insurance sector, so they come under the organized sector. And very comparatively small portion of population depends on organized sector for their livelihood. Means share of unorganized sector is more as compared to the share of organized sector in Indian economy. Okay, I hope you have understood the employment in organized and unorganized sector. Now we will move towards our next point, that is rural and urban employment. So I hope you know what is rural employment and what is urban employment. The employment opportunities which are found in rural areas, rural employment, and the employment opportunities which are found in urban area is known as urban employment. So when we talk about the rural areas, so what are the avenues or what are the opportunities for the employment in rural area? So agriculture is the most primary and the main sector which provides employment opportunities in rural areas. Okay, so most of the rural population of India depends upon the agricultural sector for their livelihood, for their survival. Okay, and when we talk about the small and the cottage industry, so even though they exist in the rural areas, still they cannot provide employment opportunities to major chunk of population like agriculture provides. So as most of the population in rural area depends upon the agriculture for their survival, for their livelihoods, okay, so agriculture and allied activities provides employment opportunities to major chunk of rural population. But if you are going to see, if you are going to focus, so you will find that agriculture is seasonal in nature. Okay, means it work can be found in agriculture only during particular season, that is only 4 to 5 months in a year, and for remaining 8 to 9 months the people who used to find the job in agriculture remains unemployed, and therefore the problem of seasonal unemployment exists in rural area. So this is the structure of rural employment. Now we will see urban employment. If you are going to talk about the employment opportunities in urban areas, so in urban areas major chunk of population finds employment in secondary and tertiary sector. It implies that most of the people are engaged in doing business, either manufacturing or trading. Most of the people are employed by those manufacturing and the trading concern, and there are many people who are working as a professional or depends upon the tertiary sector for their livelihood. Okay, so in urban area, the secondary and the tertiary sector provides employment opportunities to more and more people. Okay, so in rural areas, primary sector, that is agriculture, plays a vital role, and in urban areas, the secondary and the tertiary sector plays a vital role in providing employment opportunities to the people. But as we have discussed, in rural area the employment is seasonal in nature, because people find job in agricultural sector only for the period of 4 to 5 months, and for the remaining period they remain unemployed. So therefore they start migrating from rural areas rush to urban areas in search of employment, which puts pressure on the resources of the urban area, because of which the problem of unemployment also increases in the urban areas. So it was the structure of employment in Indian economy. So today we have seen the meaning and the concept of employment and the structure of employment in India. In our next lecture, we are going to deal with the next aspect of this chapter, that is unemployment. Till then, keep studying, stay safe. And if in case you are going to have any doubt, so you can put it on WhatsApp group or you can send personal message to me on WhatsApp and get your doubts cleared. So guys, keep studying, stay safe. Thank you.